Hi, I'm Ruben Alves, I'm from Robot Ignite Academy, and today you are going to see how to create a Catkin workspace. But before we do that, remember to visit our Robot Ignite Academy platform. If you don't know Robot Ignite Academy, it's a platform that you learn ROS online in a really practical way. You don't have to install anything. Oh, you don't have to install anything, you just open your web browser and start learning. For example, if you open this course, ROS Basics in 5 Days, by pressing this button, we have a screen like this, where you have a IDE, the simulation, and the instructions on the left side. And you also can organize the screen in different ways, so you can see the simulation better, the IDE, anything. Okay, so let's start the creation of the Catkin workspace. If you come here, or if you are a ROS developer, you have normally a folder called the Catkin workspace. If you come into this folder, we have the build, devel, and SRC, and the SRC is where our packages are created, are located, I mean. For example, here we have the exercise 414, is exactly what you can see here on the IDE, and this also compiled file, this zipped file, let's say. Okay, let's see how to create this Catkin workspace. For that, let's use our computer, in this case, my computer, of course. Okay, so let me maximize it here so you have a, you can see a better. Okay, we need Catkin installed, which normally comes with ROS. If you run and grab ROS, we can see that we have here the ROS Kinetic installed. So let's just create, we need to create a folder called Catkin workspace and with a source folder inside and this parameter to create this structure, like one folder inside the other. Okay, now we have the Catkin workspace and the source folder. If you just Catkin init workspace, we have this semake lists which make this a Catkin workspace already. But there is another way also, if you remove these semake lists, now we have just a folder called SRC, not a real Catkin workspace. But with this source folder inside of the Catkin workspace folder, we can just call Catkin make, wait some seconds, and we will have now, instead of only one, we have three folders, build, devel, and SRC. So we already have a ready Catkin workspace. It's really easy. So to start using this workspace, for example, if I create some packages on the source folder that is empty now, in order to start using these packages, we have to run source devel setup bash, because if you see this devel folder, we have here a file setup.bash, setup.bash. So in order to run this command automatically, for example, if I run roscd, you can see that I'm on the Catkin workspace devel folder. But if I open a new web shell, let me maximize it here, and I just run roscd, instead of being on the Catkin workspace, I'm on the ROS Connect folder, because this was not executed. So in order to execute this automatically, I have to put this on the bashrc file. I can do this by running executing Catkin workspace by sourcing this file, and let's put on the bashrc file. Now, if I open a new web shell and run roscd again, I'm going directly to the Catkin workspace we just created. Let me maximize again, and let's just roscd. As you can see, now we are on our the devel folder of our Catkin workspace. So now we could create packages, and the ROS would be able to find them. But the creation of ROS packages will be in a different video. So that's all for today. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you liked, don't forget to subscribe our channel. And also remember to give us a thumbs up and press the bell for a new video every single day. So, thanks for watching.